General Alfred John G.D. de Chastelain does nothing by halves. His life is so full of success, he's had to circle back to accomplish a few things more than once. He was chief of the defense staff, twice, under two opposing governments. In the history of Canada, that is a first. He's an honorary doctor, 10 times over. He's an honorary fellow at Oxford. But come on, you receive 10 honorary doctorates in a lifetime, you're an honorary fellow wherever you go. The general's international achievements are Oscar-worthy. In fact, he is overqualified to be in this film. But we are pressing on because we have learned a little something about perseverance from this guy. John's life reads like an international spy thriller, in part because it started out as one. He was born in Bucharest, Romania, to an American mother, Marion, and a Scottish father, Alfred, known to most as Chaz. During the war, Chaz ran sabotage missions for Britain's Special Operations Executive. Marion, fluent in 7 languages, was recruited by a Canadian spy leading counter-espionage for the Americans and the Brits. After the war, Chaz's hunt for work landed him an executive oil job in Calgary. John entered the military as a private with the Calgary Highlanders and then transferred to Kingston's RMC, where in 1960, he graduated with a Bachelor of Arts in History and a commission in the revered Princess Patricia's Canadian Light Infantry. From here, things move fast. He served as a company commander with the 1st Battalion of his regiment in Germany and then with the UN in Cyprus. In Winnipeg, he commanded the 2nd Battalion of the Princess Pats. He commanded the military base in Montreal during the 1976 Olympics. He returned to Cyprus as Deputy Chief of Staff of the UN Forces and Commander of the Canadian Contingent. Oh, we are just warming up. Here are some of his senior appointments. Let me take a moment to paraphrase Joe Biden. John de Chastelain is a big deal. In September of 1989, John was promoted to general. He served as the chief of the defense staff through the end of the Cold War, the First Gulf War, and the beginning of the Balkan Wars. His negotiations were critical in ending the standoff at Oka. He spent a year as ambassador to the United States. JDC might refer to this as a breather. He's been recognized with the highest orders of merit in Canada, the US, the UK, and in Greece. He's been celebrated for outstanding commitments to security, defense, and democratic values. John de Chastelain is a man with a heavy jacket. And while he's known for many things, he may be best known for the work he began in 1995. Joining the international body on arms decommissioning in Northern Ireland, he rose to become one of 3 international chairmen involved in the peace talks which led to the Good Friday Agreement. Across the globe, the general has made it his mission to resolve troubles. One imagines life at home with JDC. Trouble with your homework? Not on his watch. Trouble with the neighbors? Not a chance. Trouble with the car? Not any longer. For almost 60 years, John de Chastelain has proven through bravery, tenacity, leadership, and understanding that there are no intractable problems. There are just problems waiting for this guy to solve them.
Oh, sorry, Teresa.
He's retired.